Talk about a shot in the dark. But even with its vision blocked, this snake strikes its prey with pinpoint precision.
This blindfolded snake can strike perfectly accurately based on its thermal sensation, its ability to detect warm objects in its environment. It is literally seeing heat.
With support from the National Science Foundation, Florida Tech biologist Michael Grace and his team carefully study these reptiles' infrared sensors.
This ball python, like most boas and pythons, has an array of these infrared sensory organs called pit organs right around the mouth. So their brains have an image of the visible world and an image of the thermal world, so they see both light and heat together at the same time. Our ultimate goal is to understand the workings of the system so that maybe you could build better artificial devices. We could truly revolutionize the way infrared sensors are used in industrial applications or police purposes or military purposes.
These snakes aren't just sharpshooters, they're smart too. They can be trained to use their thermal sense to make choices and get rewards. Grace wants to learn just how sensitive those heat-sensing organs are.
They can be trained to do very complex series of behaviors.
In this experiment, kind of a game show for snakes, this Burmese python must pick a door based on whether or not it senses heat.
This animal has been trained that when the thermal stimulus is on, to choose the left push button, and this animal has made the correct choice, and it is now retrieving its dead mouse reward.
Better understanding of these snakes' thermal sensing skills could help authorities manage them in places like the Everglades, where they are an invasive species.
We recognize this exotic mega predator as a tremendous ecological threat. This infrared imaging system is certainly part of the key to their success here in the subtropics. People demonize snakes, but I just love this animal. It sort of looks like a big puppy.
A puppy? Well, handle with care. These little cuties may not bark, but they definitely bite. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.